Starfleet hasn't heard from Deep Space Station K-13 in a while. It's in a tactically sensitive part of the quadrant, and the brass is getting concerned. Get out there, find out what you can, and render assistance if needed. And hey, be careful, okay? This could go sideways fast.
Stop where you are and turn about slowly. I need to determine if you are infected. Neuroparasites. A life form last encountered by the crew of the Enterprise at Deneva Colony. Those possessed by the creatures tend to engage in hostilities with the uninfected. The better to render them fit for infestation. Temet, and while you have not engaged in hostilities thus far, I have seen infected employ false passivity in order to lure unwary prey. A tricorder scan of your adrenaline levels should verify your status. Scans show a slightly elevated level of adrenaline, though nowhere near that of an infected life form. Thank you for your patience. One can never be too cautious where these parasites are concerned. According to Starfleet data files, the parasites can be safely destroyed by exposure to high-intensity ultraviolet light. My attempts at reconfiguring the station's lighting thus far have been unsuccessful. I am a physician, not a habitat engineer. As a precaution, I have developed a serum that can render a person toxic to the creatures. However, medical supplies here are limited. I have enough serum to inoculate your landing party and one other person.
Now there's a voice I wasn't expecting. I take it you heard my distress call then. Well, in case you haven't noticed, the station's been overrun by neuroparasites. The weed devils are back with a vengeance. I'm afraid not. I'm in the auxiliary control room, down on the engineering deck. The place is filthy with parasites, so you'll understand if I don't go out for a wee jaunt.
I have secured a small amount of security gear. It may give you another edge against the parasites. To gain useful knowledge by scanning one of the infected. The creatures continue to be resistant to tricorder scans, sir. It may be fascinating. I'm detecting an unusually high level of tachyons nearby. Based on these readings, it is possible that a temporal event has occurred on the station within the last 4.2 hours.
Thank you.
The auxiliary control station is down the hall to our right. I'm reading a single human life form within the room. The biosigns match those of Commander Scott in the Starfleet medical database.
Hi there. It's good to see a friendly face. There you are. I was beginning to get a bit concerned. Thought you might have been taken by those little beasties. I'll just lock the door so none of them can get in while we discuss our next course of action. Now that you're here, we've some work to do. The way I see it, we need to get to main engineering and turn on the station's ultraviolet lighting. That'll sort the nasty bugs out properly.
While I cannot attest to the ability of UV light to sort Denovan parasites, it will initiate a complete molecular breakdown within all parasites exposed to it.
Aye, she's a Vulcan, all right. I was trying to override the lighting controls from here. It looks like someone sabotaged several Duotronic relays. We have to repair them if we're going to have any chance of saving the station. Before we go, grab yourself a kit from the crate here. It might come in handy. We better get a move on. The parasites aren't ones to loiter about.
Equip a kit to gain new ground combat abilities.
Aye, this is one of the broken relays, right here. That one was easy. Just a few more to go. Alright, there are several ways through the engineering section here. Keep in mind that the parasites tend to stay in dark corners. If you want to avoid them, do your best to stay in the lit areas. Remember, the parasites like the dark. Wee devils that they are.
Our odds of success are greatest if we remain in well-lit areas.
This one just needs new fuses.
Enemy targets uncensored.
There we are. Good as new. This may be a bit tricky. Just a wee bit longer. There we are. I'll have this fixed up straight away. That takes care of that. No trouble at all. It looks like someone has overridden the command codes. You best get to the command center and see what you can do from there. I'll stay here, barricade the door, and keep trying to get those UV lights going.
They're dying, all of them!
Salvage what you can and send a squad to kill the Federation vermin!
Actually, the name's Daniels. This may be a little difficult to absorb, but recent events may make it more plausible. I'm actually from the future. I can't tell you how far, just that it's a future worth protecting. That's why I'm here now. The aliens we're fighting are called the Nakul, and they're waging a temporal cold war with us. They're trying to change the timeline here in order to disrupt the future. Understand that I follow a temporal version of the Prime Directive. There's only so much I can reveal to you. Trust that we're doing the right thing here. Time's a factor. We need to stop the Nakul from obtaining the neural parasites. The Nakul ship that brought these invaders is now fighting the USS Ptolemy. Someone must have sent a distress call. Unfortunately, Ptolemy is no match for the Nakul. Neither is your ship, at least not alone. We should eliminate the parasites on the ships you fought earlier. Those crews will help you once their minds are their own again. It's risky, but it's our best shot here.
Transferring command codes to you now. Use them to remotely access the computer on those disabled ships and emit an ultraviolet flash inside.
This is Captain Seralt of the Ptolemy. We have engaged the enemy ship, but we are outmatched. Please restore those ships and join the fight quickly.
That did it, Captain. Looks like everyone's coming around. The parasites are gone.
This is Captain Doherty of the USS Myrmidon. What happened? What's going on? Parasites? What? Okay, sorry. We're right behind you, Captain. Lead the way.
Something's wrong. We're not doing any damage.
The Ptolemy has been destroyed. They have some kind of temporal shielding.
Temporal shielding? Never heard of it. But maybe a modular iron.
Yeah.
work, Captain. You sent those devils back to wherever they came from. We do have a wee problem, however. The burst I sent, when combined with the power source, created a feedback pulse. The feedback is creating some kind of spatial anomaly, which is beginning to pull the station in. We need to evacuate immediately. Scott here. The portal's collapsing. We're in for a right bumpy ride. Everyone's aboard. Get us clear before that portal blows. There she goes. I don't think anyone's ever seen a station do that. Perhaps not. After all, it was a temporal vortex. They may well survive. In another time. Well then, it's been quite a day, hasn't it? Neural parasites. Time-traveling raiders. Why, things will seem almost normal once I'm back on the Enterprise. Speaking of, I'm sure one of the ships here can give me a lift back to her now that they're parasite-free. If Starfleet Command gives you any grief on this, remind them that lives are more valuable than equipment. And you saved a lot of lives today.
I apologize for springing all of this on you at the last minute, and I'll explain more as soon as I can. For now, I can tell you that history is unfolding as it should, and that was not the end of K-13. You're building a fine tradition of making the right decisions in crisis situations. In the meantime, don't talk to anyone about the Na'kul or their time travel. We can't risk any further corruption of the timeline.
Let me get this straight. K-13, an entire space station, just disappeared into some type of spatial anomaly? And I thought some of Kirk's after-action reports were a little out there. Starfleet Command won't be pleased with the loss of K-13, or the people that were still on board, but they'll be happy to hear about the lives you did save. Good work out there. Keep it up. Stay safe.
Congratulations, Lieutenant.